Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Lafayette Leopards and the Villanova Wildcats. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our star watch for today's game. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
Hey, the starting five, just like a chain. It's only as strong as its weakest link. Let's see how this group plays together, Brad.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. The Wildcats win possession and they're up and running. Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, the two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
And boy, they just jump out of the gate with a score early.
They're sending the message, we're focused, baby.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I love the four-round one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. They have one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. Experience is so important, Brad. See situations and knowing how to react to them correctly and quickly is a great, great thing.
Foul shot is not good. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. That's good. Both teams looking to get things going here. He shoots from left of the circle. Can't get the shot to drop. They work it around the perimeter.
Bad decision there by the freshman.
Here they go into transition. Goes up for two. Can't put it down. Too strong. For that reason right there, that's why I love college basketball.
Wow, listen to those fans. The crowd is thunderous.
From three-point range. Off the mark. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. With Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Gave it up from three-point land. The missed shot on the dribble. Gives it up. Him with the ball.
Spacing's so important. Where's he going? Where's he going?
Delaney comes up with it. The Wildcats are on the run. Kicks it out. Number 32 is charged with the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
Hey, being a student in college is quite an experience, but being a student athlete is something on a whole other level. There are a lot of challenges you have to meet if you want to keep your balance and be successful.
Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the outside, puts up the jumper. You can't be that aggressive. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Steps to the line for the freebie. First one, good. Second shot, no good. Stout handles the pass.
Up and inside.
Number 14 is called for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Shots no good. Inside. Tries for two. Drains it. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
You know, Brad, as a coach, you teach your players to read the defender. And when he's not looking, deliver the pass.
Off the glass and no good. Gave it up. Number 32 picks up the foul. Third team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Goes to the line for the first time. Misses his first shot. Not a very good night at the line, Dick.
Absolutely no excuse for that, Brad. No excuse.
Misses the free one. Dick, this team is having some serious problems at the free throw line.
And it's a collective effort by all of them tonight.
In the lane. And nice looking jumper in the lane. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Obvious foul. He gets the tough layup and a foul to go with it, Dick.
Hey, that was awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Can he hit the free throw and get the three-point play? He makes it. Trying to feed inside with the jumper. They get it to go. Jenkins receives the ball. Goes up with a shot. Busts the J. This is getting ugly.
Hey, if you can't check your man, it's up to the coach to recognize that and make an adjustment.
For two. He gets the bucket to fall. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Missed the jumper.
Oh, what a high riser. Great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
Looking for a good shot. He goes for three.
Excellent jump shot right there.
He can put points up and he can move the ball.
Hey, when the scorer is able to read and react to pressure like this, holes start showing up in the defense.
Buries it home. Both teams looking to get things going here. Momentary look from three-point land. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper scorches the net. Now they work it around the perimeter. To shoot now. You betcha. Defenders right up on him. Top of the circle. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if he were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
You can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Gives it up. Goes up for two. This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Tight D here. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
He attempts the jump shot. Off the mark. They go into the low block. Jumper. He makes the jumper. We've got a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. Ready to start again. On the left side, from the corner.
How many bricks did we see? Will somebody make a jump shot, please? They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Gets the J to fall. Moving it around the perimeter for two. Can't get it to go. He looks for three. Can't connect. Number 11 receives the ball. Gave it up. For the bucket. Sinks it. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
They feel they are more successful when they focus their attention on doing a bit of both, Brad. They have the personnel to be able to play up-tempo at one end and play in the half court at the other.
From the corner, goes in. Goes up for two. He gets it to go. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Cross court. And it's blocked. Number 11 handles the pass. And score it. Jenkins handles the feed, takes the jumper, missed it, buries it. Working it around the perimeter. There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
He pulls up with a jumper. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. Takes his jumper, scorches the net with a J. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up. Off the mark. For two. Busts the jumper. Looking for a good shot. 6 minutes left on the game clock.
Turnover committed by the senior. Look at speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
Knocks it down. They work the perimeter. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Turnover by the senior. Now looking to attack. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number 11 takes the feed.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Tries for two. He comes up empty. On the left side. On the outside, he fires it up. The missed shot. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
I tell you, that was a great backdoor play. Terrific execution right there. The defense stopped concentrating for a second and they got beat back door.
The Leopards are down as we head into the timeout. Change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He pulls the trigger. And yet another missed field goal attempt, Dick.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad, and you know that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse.
Gave it up. The turn of fadeaway jumper.
You talk about versatility. There aren't many guys that are going to make that fadeaway jump shot. Great touch. Impossible to block that shot.
For two, it sticks. Puts up the J. Nope. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. For the bucket, gets it to fall. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
Well, those aggressive moves to the basket are what this offense is all about.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from downtown.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two. Can't connect. Gave it up. We're at the 2 minute mark. On the dribble, gives it up. He goes up with it. Jumper won't go. On the left side, looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. It almost looks like they got a lid on the goal, Dick. Nothing is falling for them.
They couldn't hit the ocean with a beach ball right now, Brad. That was some of my players. That's why I got fired. What an embarrassment.
From three-point territory, off the mark, pushes it up. An errant pass out of bounds for the turnover.
Well, you credit that to two factors. One, great team defense, but number two, lack of communication offensively, not in rhythm and sync.
Gave it up. Rejected. And we're going the other way. On the dribble, gives it up. 1 minute left to go. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Pushes it up. From beyond the arc. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
Dumps it in. From downtown. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Gave it up. From the corner, he misses the bomb.
There it is, Jam City.
With the big shot. Missed it. At the end of the first half, the Leopards are down by 8. Villanova has made a statement by crashing the boards in the first half, Dick.
Very, very strong statement. They're letting the opposition know that they're not going to give them any second chance opportunities. And that speaks volumes, baby.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. They're working around the perimeter. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up.
Sort of dump down inside. Nobody rotated down up on top.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Wildcats. Coaching staff were very impressed with the team's ability to push the ball in transition. They realize that they are at their best when they get down the court before the offense has a chance to set up. Dick, you mentioned this in your points of emphasis as being vital to their success. Now it just needs to continue in the second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Didn't look like anything was going to keep him from the basket there, Dick.
You know, he did a great job putting the ball on the floor and getting to the basket.
In the post, he tries the jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
On the outside. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Goes up with it. They got it. On the right side. On the dribble, gives it up for two. Shot off. Number 11 handles the pass.
Up and inside.
He shoots from the deep corner. Nails the jumper. To perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He puts up the J.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Puts up the runner. Shots off the mark. Number 24 is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Number 32 steps to the line for the first time. He buries it. Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Backcourt violation.
Carelessness with the ball is never a good thing.
Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
On the left side. This shot. Delaney handles the pass. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
Hey, pandemonium is in full effect.
Nope. Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job with his footwork to create the drop step.
That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Jenkins receives the pass. They work it around the perimeter. From way outside. Bust the J. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
For the bucket, makes the shot. He cut back door and received the pass.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time.
He takes a three.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man.
Goes up for two. Makes it. Gave it up. Tries for two. Goes. Gives it up. He attempts the trifecta. He misses the fadeaway. Looking for a good shot. For two, he drains the jumper. The crowd starting to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Missed the jumper. Number 24 receives the pass. Momentary look from three-point land and score it. Now they work it around the perimeter. Puts up the tray. He misses the J.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
Puts up the jumper. He misses the J. Dick, I'm really impressed at how quickly they get back on defense.
I'm more impressed with how quickly they respond to the correct rotations.
Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
Gave it up. He launches a three. Scores it. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. Ready to get things back going again after the timeout. Jarrett receives the pass. He goes up with it. All these missed shots. I don't even think they're giving the ball a chance to go in, Dick.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad, and you know that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse. That spacing.
Takes the outside jumper. Can't connect. He gets the rejection. Wow. He's seemingly at an emotional low right now.
He's got to snap out of it. His team needs him.
The Wildcats are perennial favorites in their conference.
Hey, good isn't enough. For the people who are associated with this school, they want to be the best.
The mark. Working it around the perimeter. He attempts the jump shot. Missed it. Number 11 takes the feed. Looking for a good shot. The senior commits a turnover. Pushes it up. Jumper. They work the perimeter. Stop and pop. And come up short. Puts up the shot. Nope. The shooting guard with the ball. On the outside. He shoots from the deep corner. Knocked it down. Jenkins receives the pass. He pulls up with a jumper. Missed the jumper. The point guard takes the pass. We're at the 7-minute mark. He goes up with it. Jumper won't go. For the bucket. Knocks it down. A little two-man action.
I'll tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
The student section is all rallied up, and they are ready to battle.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
With the jumper off the mark. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number 11 receives the ball. We're at the 6-minute mark.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots the jumper. The missed shot. Pushes it up. Corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Turnover committed by the senior. Way out on the right wing. He shoots from right of the circle. About 5 minutes remaining. Trying to feed the low block. Goes up with a shot. Off the mark. Off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Jumper. Nails the J. Down low, puts it on the floor. To ride a fadeaway. I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
It's crazy in here, Brad.
Nothing but joy and delight in the stands right now. These fans realize that this game is out of reach, Dick.
That's what the fans came to see. Their team win. 5 points, 10 points, 20 points, it doesn't matter. Bad decision there by the senior.
Fed the low block. With the J. Nails the jumper. Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. They're working around the arc. With a deep shot from outside. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Attempts the three, busts the jumper. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
On the outside. For two. It's good. Gave it up. 2 minutes left on the game clock. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the three. Nope. Pushes it up. Away. Missed it.
Up and inside. Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
They work it around the perimeter. From the corner, nails a sweet jumper. Takes the jumper. They got it. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner. The missed shot. Had a momentary look from three-point land. He puts up the J. Off the mark. Number 11 takes the feed. For two, he gets it to fall. It inside. They move it into the front court.
There he is. Strips the ball loose.
Launches it. The shot won't fall. And here, Dick, we have our players of the game.
Just two great players with some fantastic performances here tonight.